No, ain't no cap in it. I like put a stack in it. I'm bout to buy that. Stop it, cause it ain't no acting it. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. Leaving my mark like a. I see no biggie.
First off, let me talk my... Got a couple things I gotta cross off my list. How you insomniac for sleeping on my... It's a bad soundtrack, read the script. Born in the motherland, headed straight down to the south. Tennessee mornings with pops, working three jobs. I knew that they struggled to get it, that's why I wanted to get it. That embedded, you get it? Treat it like a law. And I'ma need commission for this hit. Lance laid the canvas and I painted over it. I don't need a vision board to show you I'm the... I'm betting on myself... Chips.
Got it. Made some choices for a profit. That's my logic. I'ma take it to the coffin. Just being honest.
Try to sink my ship like Titanic and leave me with Jack. Hope I be panicking, but I rose to the top. Isn't it funny that the is built like a Maserati, yoga folding like origami?
One, I walk the walk. I talk the talk. I be saying what I want. When I had no deposit, closet was looking real bare. Now I made a deposit, my closet's looking super rare. Drove it really far. Crazy how did this happen?
With Chesapeake Bay gleaming in the distance, we are inside M&T Bank Stadium near the Inner Harbor in Baltimore, Maryland. Today, we've got a Week 13 matchup for you here between the Denver Broncos and the Baltimore Ravens. Turn to December, and we're in the home stretch now as we're underway in Week 13. This one fielded at the 5. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. Start the drive with Hill. And that's not the start that he was looking for, as he's going to be met and dropped behind the line. It'll go as a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Play action. Now Jackson. And that's going to be caught. It's James Prochet. And able to get this one across the 45. The ball is brought down. 18 yards the pick up there. Move the chains.
Barney, you know when we call a game, we talk about Lamar Jackson and his speed, his elusiveness, and the ability to get him on the ground, how tough that is for a defense. But how about his development as a thrower, as a professional?
First carry for the former Buckeye, J.K. Dobbins. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3. The Ravens at 7-4 on the year. They come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victories, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
Now Dobbins again on second down. And he's got some space here. And he is tackled inside the 49 to the 35. They get 14 on that lead. It's good for Baltimore first down.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to the linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon.
As
a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
That one complete to Prochet. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's 3rd and 10. This defense for the Broncos, they were very strong last week in the win over Carolina.
And I think our statistician, we ended up having to bring the blue tent and put it around him for a while because he was developing a hand injury from having to write down all the turnovers this team forced. 5, 6, 7, 8. Absolutely unbelievable.
And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line. Nick Bonito in there to get him. And on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him. And I tell you what, he got it from 58. That had lots of leg behind it. And the Ravens strike first at 3-0. They were probably hoping to get him a little bit closer for a shorter field goal, but he was able to get it done from deep.
Nice little tester for him to begin things, huh? I think he was open for a little bit more of a chip shot. Instead, they made him stretch it out a little bit, but he's got to feel great now that he put it through the pipes.
So 1st and 10 here for Wilson and the Broncos at their own 25-yard line. They start the drive on the ground. It's Williams. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. To throw is Wilson. Open man downfield is Judy. He's got it. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. Now a 1st down carry. It's Williams. And he can only manage to get a couple. 2nd and 8 coming up.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Now Wilson. Flush to his right. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. The rushing numbers for Wilson maybe down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the 1st down. Throwing is Wilson. Open man, he completes it to Judy. And they'll work this down inside the 30.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short game.
Throwing again on 2nd down. Wilson. That's taken in by Gorsuch. Down inside the 10. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. A big play that time on the catch and run. And the Broncos are going to have a new set of downs. That's a jet sweep. Wilson with a little pop pass. And he is going to lose yardage here. This defense not fooled one bit on that touch pass.
And this has become one of those kind of in vogue plays, you know, kind of like the shuffle pass was a few years ago. This one never got off the ground, but you understand why a lot of teams are running it. These wide receivers, a lot of them, they've run like running backs with the ball in their hands.
On 2nd and goal, Wilson. And this is caught by Sutton. Touchdown, Broncos. A great play there. With touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Broncos are able to answer the early 3 points and take a 1st quarter lead. Extra point from McManus is good, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get him 3. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, if that isn't for coaches to know that they've got a kicker to do and run this distance. Now, that is, as a defensive player, you don't want that in your head too much when you're relying on it. And he goes out.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's 2nd and 2. Here's Jackson. And he fires one incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
After the incompletion, here now, 3rd and 2. They'll try to run for it with Dobbins. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. 4th down, and out comes Jordan Stout here to punt. He punted 5 times in the win last week as this one's away. Taking it about the 16. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And the Broncos take over. 1st down and 10. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive.
Well, the football changing hands here, and as this offense takes the field, Charles, they'd be fine with more of the same on this upcoming drive.
And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And it's picked up by the Ravens. And he's got Rome. And this is going to be brought back for a Baltimore touchdown. Huge, huge play by the defense, not only to force the fumble, obviously, but to return it for a touchdown.
And I know it's no fun for anyone who plays offense, but isn't it fun to see how a defense rallies when there's a fumble return? Everyone tries to find something to bring it all the way up.
I always like their celebrations because they don't get there that often.
No, they're not choreographed very well usually.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And let's just say they're going to be looking to start over on this drive. A few moments ago, they were in the exact situation, but their first play led to a fumble that was returned for 6.
Yeah, you definitely have to have a short memory to play in the NFL. You got to remember what you did wrong so you don't repeat it. But you can't dwell on it, because then you will repeat it. And that's what you don't want to do.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on 1st and 10. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. And it's picked up by the Ravens.
I know that taking care of the football is something that's drummed into every guy who plays this position, no matter what, whether it's running it in the pocket, out of the pocket.
But it's almost surprising to me that there aren't more fumbles by that position because of the way that they get attacked on each and every play.
Yeah, well, he had the fumble last week. Now here's 2 weeks in a row with a fumble loss.
Concentration has got to be there, and he's got to understand how much time he has to take care of a play. And maybe his clock is off just a little bit.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Michael O.J. Nudia. And the Broncos are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. Boy, the coverage there, airtight as he comes away with the interception.
Love that observation there because they were taking a shot in the end zone, but you're right about the coverage. Absolutely tremendous. And this they could click for a training tape. Staying with him down the field, locates the football in the air, and comes away with the interception.
Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. Well, let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. Three-yard gains. That means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you got to run fast. Of course, you got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness is a premium for all of that now.
Out route complete to Dulcich. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. Here's Wilson to throw. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
He did an okay job of absorbing the hit, just couldn't secure the football through the catch.
And he was right there on the spot and forced the incompletion. That's something defenders work on all the time. If you're there, make the contact, but continue to work your way through the receiver so that you can't possess the football and turn it into a catch.
Escaping the pressure right. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
I'm not quite sure what he thought he saw there, but the reality was certainly a much different picture than what he anticipated. And give credit to the defense. They were down on the flash when he broke out of there, and it forced him out with almost nothing to show for his efforts.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Good push up front, and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they were able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
Two minutes remaining in the first half, 10-7, our score. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Again, it's Williams. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
His pass caught at the 4. Touchdown, Broncos. Russell Wilson with 2 first-half touchdown passes. And the Broncos are once again back in front. McManus's point after is good, and the lead is now 14-10. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
For this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the...
Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line.
Well, those have been a problem for them all season, but never quite as much as they have in these last few minutes. Let's count it up now. A pair of picks on his team's last two drives and double-digit interceptions this season. I don't care if you're the best in the game or an undrafted rookie. You've got to take better care of the football or you're going to cost your team chances.
And they're going to move it down to inside the 25. Up the middle, it's Williams. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. They go play action now. Wilson. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up, not that time. Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. And he's going to go down. He sacked back at the 24. Adafe Owe, the outside linebacker, dropping him for a loss of 6.
Traditionally, as a defense, your number one job, stop the run. But in today's football, it's impacted the opposing quarterback. Make him uncomfortable. And so far, they've not been able to do that.
Not at all. He's been really comfortable in the pocket. 3 touchdown passes already.
So that could be an important first sack if they do want to turn things around.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete. Off the left field in a bad spot. But fortunately, it's just an incompletion and not picked to bring up 4th down.
Oh, that's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing 4th down.
4th down, Wilson trots off, and on comes Brandon McManus for the Denver field goal. From the left hash, this will be a 41-yarder. The kick by McManus is good, and that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. So they get the turnover in plus territory. The drive stalls out, but still able to get 3 out of that.
Yeah, we were able to see an offense and a defense kind of mix and match with each other, didn't we? Both of them trying to make sure that they have the upper hand and the advantage. Offense trying to get to the end zone. Defense, of course, trying to hold them to a field goal attempt. And it wasn't a guaranteed lock 3 from where they started. So, you know, the offense has to be happy to come away with those 3 points.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these 2 teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Broncos with a lead, and they will be receiving this kickoff here as quarter 3 is underway. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And despite the turnovers, Charles, and they had multiple in that first half, they still have the lead as they begin this third quarter.
And they probably heard some conflicting tones at the half, don't you think? A lot of praise for what they did to get this lead, but also a little bit of scolding because they got to take better care of the football in the second half. But you and I both know the great leaders, they know how to give that little bit of vinegar in there and cover it with a big dose of honey.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, 2nd and 10 from the 25. Here's Wilson. And he fires one that's intercepted. It's Chuck Clark picking it off. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind. And we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the five down to the three.
If you're going to keep these guys out of the end zone, you've got to be able to commit to stopping the run. And that's a nice job there, getting the safeties involved in run support.
So the ball position now at the three. Here's second and goal. Dobbins once more. And he's not going too far. In fact, stopped dead in his tracks at the three. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Hey, Miller.
Third and goal, Jackson. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So they opted to pass for it on third and goal. Let's see what they do on fourth and goal.
Well, I think they threw it with the idea that if they didn't get it, they would go for it on fourth and goal. So they've got another play in their pocket. They're going to have to call it right now. No field goal here.
Tucker's kick is good. So kind of disappointing there. I mean, yes, they get the three, but with starting field position like that, three's not what you're banking on.
No, and you just have to wonder if you can afford to let chances like that continue to pass you by. You've got to find ways to get the ball into the end zone and put sixes on the scoreboard.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
Meanwhile, Wilson's throw caught here by Dulcich. So back-to-back plays, each get nothing. And third and eight now.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. You're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. On third down, Wilson. And he'll find Washington. That's complete. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Whenever we talk about moving the sticks and controlling the football, there's a great example right there. Those are the third downs you need to convert to win football games. We're in the third quarter of this one, and this is a tight one. In order to maintain pace, keep the ball away from the other team, and put points on the board, those are the plays they need to continue to convert.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 63 yards rushing for him here as he starts to draw closer to a 1,000-yard campaign. After he cleared the line of scrimmage, nice little hole developed.
Yeah, great blocking right there at the start. But how about his vision, finding the open spaces and letting his feet carry him to them?
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Now a 10th carry. Here's Williams. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Javonte Williams, his 5th rushing touchdown now on the year. And the Broncos are in for 6. Extra point from McManus is good. And that pushes the lead up to 11. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away.
This will be fielded inside the five. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
The Ravens take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line set to get going. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. That's good for 28 yards. So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 43. Out of the pistol, here's Hill. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Jackson going to keep it running right. And he is going to lose yardage here. He'll have to deal with a second and 14 now after the loss. Off the play fake. Here's Jackson. That's complete to the fullback, Ricard. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. They'll go with Hill here on first down. And here he'll get it down to the 7. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Third down, Jackson. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Nick Bonito able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. Tucker's kick is good, and that'll make this an 8-point game. So that one is his third of the game. Now, if you're wondering, that's only halfway to his career high, as he once had 6 field goals.
Oh, Brandon, but was 6? Let's hope we don't get that again, please. Okay, can we see a few touchdowns here and there?
That'd be nice. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play, and that's how they got it done.
Yeah, they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here. A real field flipper there, as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the... From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Now it's Wilson. And this is caught by Sutton. Touchdown, Broncos. Making a hat trick for Russell Wilson. 3 touchdown passes now. And the Broncos add on to their lead, and they are also closing in on a 5th straight victory. McManus's point after is good, and the lead is up to 15 now. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Thank you. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And last time able to get three. That's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six.
And Jackson cannot get away, and he'll go down. Multiple players getting home there for an 8-yard loss. And they weren't in zone coverage. They were in man, and each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old-school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a Defensive Player of the Year at the other, and they just locked people down.
And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Nick Bonito able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon.
Remember, throughout my career here in defensive coaches always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. They put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. It'll be a gain of four, but it won't be enough. It leaves him with a fourth down now.
As much as I praise teams for being true to who they are, in this situation, I wonder if maybe they outguessed themselves a little bit. Third down, seemed like an obvious passing situation. They chose to run it and didn't get anywhere close to a first down.
Steps away to his left. And this is going to be hauled in by the tight end, Andrews.
And he is going to have a Ravens first down. And that was something else. A big pickup on fourth and long to give him a new set of downs.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown.
J.K. Dobbins scampering home from 19 yards out. And the Ravens are able to make some inroads here to that deficit.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point as this gets him back into the touchdown and a two-point conversion. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
This will be fielded inside the five. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You've got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have three timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit. And you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, I mean, by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
They'll try and run down some clock with Williams. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. Well, at this stage, that's exactly what you want offensively. Good run on first down, stay in bounds, keep that clock rolling.
And look at that play chart that the play caller has in his hands right now. That's what you got to focus in on, because that's divided up by sections. And right now, he's looking at that 4-minute offense section. What running plays do we have to bleed down the clock and take care of the football? Right now, they're executing really well.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Now it's Wilson. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted.
Kyle Hamilton picks it, and the Ravens are right back in this football game.
Oh, and I saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure.
Oh, and for the third time, Jackson going to be intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And the Broncos will take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line.
The Broncos on the field ready to start their next drive.
Good old bullshit.
The interception for the last drive. He'll look to throw. Wilson hits. It's out. Fumble. And it's picked up by the Ravens. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line. Baltimore with good starting field position as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. He was unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
A gain there of 21 yards. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Jackson to throw. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked up by Michael Ojemudia. And the Broncos have just about sewn up this football game. The Broncos onto the field ready to start their next drive. Well, they can smell victory, partner. They can see it on the horizon, but certainly we're not done yet here. Defense still has three timeouts, and obviously this is a very slim lead they're holding on to.
And let's face it, the easiest way to get this done, challenge your ground game, challenge your offensive line, your tight ends, your receivers, anyone who's going to lay down a block. Don't let there be penetration because they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and maybe bring extra people to the ball. If you can do that, make them burn their timeouts, run out the clock, life will be good. But if you really want to gamble a little bit, a quick play action, quick throw, might be able to get it done. Just make sure it's not incomplete and stop the clock.
Now Wilson. That's going to be caught by Judy. And that's good for a gain of 6, and it'll be second down. Now a timeout called for by the defense, as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Wilson wants to throw it. He'll get that complete to Alvaro. On the move past the 40. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. Here's Wilson. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and that's going to bring up second down. Throwing now is Wilson. That'll go as a loss of 9, and it leads to third down. Now a timeout called for by the defense, as he'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Wilson to throw. And this would have been intercepted if he could have gotten the feed in. He didn't, so it's incomplete. Well, that one really could have turned this thing upside down. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This to perhaps salt this one away. The kick by McManus is good. And that will extend their lead even further.
So that, not just important to the fact that it widens their lead, but really that was a textbook job of just hanging on to the football.
And we know all the time that coaches talk about time of possession. Sometimes it's a stat that doesn't matter much, but in this drive, it matters a lot. They want to reduce time and score points and lock this game down.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. What do you do here down like this in this situation? Do you maybe just pick something out of the playbook you haven't called in a while, or you call it a day?
You can do that, or you pick something that's a staple for you and should work better and try and execute that on the way out the door and maybe get back to base and feel a little bit better as you end up, as you end a ball game that's been a frustrating one for you.
We'll see if they go back to base. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Caden Stearns. And the Broncos come up with a late turnover, but it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over. So this one will wind up a Denver victory.
Yeah.